Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjali Ammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture on the subject Design of Transmission Systems. And this is lecture number 7.2. We are going to solve problems in the bevel gear design. In the earlier lecture, we discussed the procedure for design of bevel gear using the PSG Design Data book. And in this lecture, we will solve two problems in the bevel gear design from the Anna University question paper. The learning outcome to the student at the end of the lecture, the student will be able to design bevel gear using the PSG Design Data book. The first example from the question paper May 2013 and May 2016. Design a bevel gear drive to transmit 7 kilowatt at 1600 rpm for the following data. Gear ratio 3, material for pinion and the steel and the gear are C45 steel. Life is 10,000 hours. So, we write down the given data. The power to be transmitted 7 kilowatt, pinion speed 1600 rpm, speed ratio I equal to 3, material C45. For both pinion and the gear, life is 10,000 hours. First, we will calculate the speed ratio. It is given in the problem. So, 3 is the speed ratio. Then, the material for the pinion, it is also given C45 and the ultimate tensile strength 7,000 kilogram force per centimeter square and the yield strength 3,600 kilogram force per centimeter square for the C45 material. We calculate the nominal twisting moment to be transmitted by the pinion. So, MT equal to 97,420 into power in kilowatt divided by the speed in RPM. So, 97,420 into 7 divided by 1600 equal to 1136.6 kilogram force centimeter. Then we calculate the design torque. So, initially we take KKD equal to 1.3. So, MT design torque equal to MT into KKD 1136.6 into 1.3 equal to 1477.5 kilogram force centimeter. Then we take the equivalent Young's modulus for steel from the table number 9, page number 8.14, 2.15 in 10 power 6 kilogram force per centimeter square. Then we calculate the design surface stress. The equation is available in the page number 8.16 PSG data book. For C45 material, surface hardened, from the table we take coefficient CR equal to 55. And HRC, Rockwell C hardness number 265, life factor equal to 1 for 10,000 hours. So, sigma C equal to CR HRC KCL, which is 55 into 265 into 1 equal to 14,575 kilogram force per centimeter square. Then we take psi y equal to 3 from PSG data book, table number 13, for I equal to 3. Then we calculate the minimum cone distance. The equation is available in the page number 8.13, table 8. R is greater than or equal to psi y into I square plus 1 to the power 0.5 into cubic root of 0.72 divided by psi y minus 0.5 into sigma c whole square into E into MT design torque divided by I. Substituting numerical values, R is greater than or equal to 3 into 3 square plus 1 to the power 0.5 into cubic root of 0.72 divided by 3 minus 0.5 into 14,575 whole square into 2.15 into 10 power 6 into 1477.5 divided by 3. Calculating, the cone distance should be greater than or equal to 7.07 centimeter. Then we have to calculate the bending stress. To calculate the bending stress, we require KBL parameter, life factor for bending. From table number 22, we take 1. K sigma stress concentration factor from table number 21, 1.2 for steel case hardened, N equal to factor of safety equal to 2.5 for steel surface hardened, and sigma minus 1 endurance limit, limit stress, sigma minus 1 equal to 0.22 sigma u plus sigma y in plus 500, that is equal to 0.22 into 7000 plus 3600 plus 500 equal to 2832 kilogram force per centimeter square. Then we calculate the design bending stress. The equation is available in the page number 8.18. sigma b equal to 1.4 into kbl divided by n into k sigma into sigma minus 1 kilogram force per centimeter square. So sigma b equal to 1.4 into 1 divided by 2.5 into 1.2 into 2832 equal to 1321.6 kilogram force per centimeter square. Then we assume number of teeth on the pinion, it is not given. We have to take between 17 to 20. We take Z1 equal to 17. Then virtual number of teeth on the pinion. So first we have to calculate delta 1, which is tan inverse of 1 by I. It is tan inverse of 1 by 3 equal to 18.43. Virtual number of teeth ZV equal to Z1 divided by cos delta 1. So 17 divided by cos 18.43 equal to 18. Now we take the form factor YV equal to 0.308 from table number 40 for ZV equal to 80. Then we calculate the average module. So for psi m equal to 10, initially we take psi m equal to 10. So average module, the equation is available in the page number 8.13a. So m average greater than or equal to 1.28 into mt design torque divided by yv sigma b psi m z1 to the power 1 by 3. So substituting all numerical values, average module is greater than or equal to 1.28 into 1477.5 divided by 0.308 into 1321.6 into 10 into 17 to the power 1 by 3 equal to 0.355 centimeter. Then we calculate the transverse module. So for transverse module, we require B, face width of the gear, so which is R by psi y. R we calculate as 7.07 divided by psi y equal to 2.36. So MT equal to M average module plus B by Z1 sin delta 1, 0.355 plus 2.36 divided by 17 into sin 18.43 equal to 0.4 centimeter. So next higher module, so 0.4 centimeter is also a standard value. So we fix the module, transverse module, as 0.4 centimeter, which is 4 millimeter. Then we take the properties, calculate the properties of the bevel gear drive. So the equations are available in the table number 31, page number 8.38. Number of teeth in the gear, Z1 equal to I into Z1, 3 into 17 equal to 51. PCD of pinion, D1 equal to MT into Z1, 0.4 into 17 equal to 6.8 centimeter. PCD of the gear, D2 equal to MT into Z2, 0.4 into 51 equal to 20.4 centimeter. Tip diameter of the pinion, DA1 equal to MT into Z1 plus 2 cos delta 1, which is 0.4 into 17 plus 2 into cos 18.43 equal to 7.56 centimeter. And tip diameter of the gear, DA2 equal to MT into Z2 plus 2 cos delta 1, which is equal to 0.4 into 51 plus 2 into cos 18.43 equal to 21.16 centimeter. Then we calculate the cone distance. So the cone distance R equal to 0.5 into MT into square root of Z1 square plus Z2 square, which is 0.5 into 0.4 into square root of 17 square plus 51 square equal to 10.75 centimeter. The value is higher than the previous value. So earlier we calculated 7.07 centimeter. Now actual cone distance for the diameter of the pinion and the gear, it is 10.75 centimeter. Then the face width, we have two equations, B equal to R by psi y, 10.75 divided by 3 equal to 3.58 centimeter, and B equal to 10 into MT, so 10 into 0.4 equal to 4 centimeter. So we fix B equal to 3.58 centimeter, the smaller value. So here in the bevel gear, we have to take the smaller value for the face width. Then the average pitch diameter of the pinion, bevel pinion, so D1 average MT into Z1 into R minus 0.5B divided by R equal to 0.4 into 17 into 10.75 minus 0.5 into 3.58 divided by 10.575 equal to 5.67 centimeter. And we require B by D1 average 3.58 divided by 5.67 equal to 0.63. Now the load concentration factor from table number 14 for the bevel gear, so equal to 1.11 for BHN value less than 350 for the pinion material, and the B by D1 average equal to 0.63. So there are two parameters to select the K value. Then we calculate the pitch line velocity. So V equal to pi D1 average N1 divided by 60, which is equal to pi into 0.0567 into 1600 divided by 60 equal to 4.7 meters per second. Now the dynamic load factor from table number 15 equal to 1 for the velocity, pitch line velocity, V equal to 4.7 meters per second. Then design torque, we calculate the design torque for checking. So design torque equal to MT into KKD. So 1136.6 into 1.1 into 1 equal to 1250.26 kilogram per centimeter. Now we have to check for the surface stress. The equation is there in the page number 8.13. Sigma C equal to 0.72 divided by R minus 0.5B into square root of I square plus 1 to the power 1.5 divided by IB into E into design torque. So substituting numerical values, 0.72 divided by 10.75 minus 0.5 into 3.58 into square root of 3 square plus 1 to the power 1.5 divided by 3 into 3.58 into 2.15 into 10 power 6 into 1250.26. Calculating, the value is 7148.9, which is less than 14575 kilogram force per centimeter square. So the actual compressive stress is less than the design compressive stress, so the design is safe. Then we have to check for the bending stress. We take alpha, pressure angle 20 degree always. Sigma B equal to R into square root of I square plus 1 divided by R capital R minus 0.5 B square whole square into design torque divided by BM YV cos alpha. So substituting the values, sigma B equal to 10.75 into square root of 3 square plus 1 divided by 10.75 minus 0.5 into 3.58 whole square into design torque 1250.26 divided by 3.58 into 0.4 into 0.308 into cos 20. So calculating, sigma B equal to 1277.35, which is lower than 1321.6 kilogram force per centimeter square. So the actual bending stress is less than the design bending stress, so the design is safe. So this is what the procedure for solving the bevel gear problem. So we have a set of procedure. You take the equations from the pages in the design data book, and the data required for calculating the parameter, it is also available in the data book. So select the data, select the equation properly, follow the procedure and solve the problem. The next question from May 2011 and November 2015 question paper. Design a straight bevel gear drive between two shafts at right angles to each other. Speed of the pinion shaft is 360 rpm and speed of the gear wheel shaft is 120 rpm. The pinion is of steel and the wheel of cast iron. Each gear is expected to work 2 hours per day for 10 years. So write down the given data. So power equal to 9.37 kilowatt, N1 equal to 360 rpm, N2 equal to 120 rpm, material pinion C45 and gear cast iron, life is 2 hours per day for 10 years equal to 7300 hours. So speed ratio we have to calculate. First step, I equal to N1 by N2, so 360 divided by 120 equal to 3. So N1 is the pinion speed, N2 is the wheel speed, so 360 divided by 120 equal to 3. Then material for the pinion is C45 given in the problem. So we have to take the properties of the pinion material for all our design calculations. Sigma U equal to 7000 kilogram force per centimeter square and sigma Y equal to 3600 kilogram force per centimeter square. So nominal twisting moment we have to calculate. So MT equal to 97420 into power in kilowatt divided by the pinion speed. 97,420 into 9.37 divided by 360 equal to 2,535.6 kilogram force centimeter. Then we calculate the design torque. Initially we take KKD equal to 1.3. So design torque MT within bracket equal to MT into KKD, which is 2,535.6 into 1.3 equal to 3,296.3 kilogram force centimeter. Then we take the equivalent X modulus. So we have two materials now for Young's modulus, for pinion steel and wheel cast iron. For the steel cast iron combination, the equivalent Young's modulus is 1.7 into 10 power 6 kilogram force per centimeter square from table number 9, page 8.14. Then design surface stress, we have to calculate the design surface stress. Equation is there in the page number 8.16. For C45 material, the coefficient is 55 and rock wall C hardness number 265. Life in number of cycles, 60 into N into T, 60 into 360 into 7300 equal to 1.6 in 10 power 8. When life is more than 10 power 7 cycles, then the life factor equal to 1 for both bending and the surface stress. So sigma C equal to CR HRC KCL 55 into 265 into 1 equal to 14,575 kilogram force per centimeter square. Then we take the psi y equal to 3 for I equal to 3 from the table number 13 in page number 8.15. Then we calculate the minimum cone distance. The equation is there in the page number 8.13, table number 8. R is greater than or equal to psi y into I square plus 1 to the power 0.5 into cubic root of 0.72 divided by psi y minus 0.5 into sigma c design compressive stress whole square into E into MT divided by I. So, substituting all the numerical values, 3 into 3 square plus 1 to the power 0.5 into cubic root of 0.72 divided by 3 minus 0.5 into 14,575 whole square into 1.7 into 10 to the power 6 into 3296.3 divided by 3. So, calculating the cone distance should be greater than or equal to 8.54 centimeter. Then we take the parameter for calculating the bending stress, design bending stress. KBL, life factor for bending equal to 1. K sigma, stress concentration factor for steel 1.2. Factor of safety from table number 20, 2.5 for the steel surface hardened. Endurance limit stress for the steel, sigma minus 1 equal to 0.22 into sigma u plus 500. So, 0.22 into 7000 plus 3600 plus 500 equal to 2832 kilogram force per centimeter square. Then we calculate the design bending stress, sigma b equal to 1.4 into KBL divided by n into K sigma into sigma minus 1. The equation is available in the page number 8.18. Substituting numerical values, sigma b design bending stress equal to 1.4 into 1 divided by 2.5 into 1.2 into 2832 equal to 1321.6 kilogram force per centimeter square. Then we take the number of teeth for the pinion. Again we take Z1 equal to 17 and we calculate the virtual number of teeth on the pinion. So Z delta 1 equal to tan inverse of 1 by I, which is tan inverse of 1 by 3 equal to 18.43, and ZB equal to Z1 divided by cos delta 1, which is 17 divided by cos 18.43 equal to 18. Now we take the form factor, which is equal to 0.308 for ZB equal to 18 from table number 40, page number 8.53. Then we calculate the average module. So the equation is there in the page number 8.13a. You take psi m equal to 10 initially. The equation m average is greater than or equal to 1.28. into design torque divided by the form factor in the design bending stress psi m z1 to the power 1 by 3. Substitute numerical values. Average module is greater than or equal to 1.28 into 3296.3 divided by 0.308 into 1321.6 into 10 into 17 to the power 1 by 3 equal to 0.464 centimeter. Then we calculate the transverse module. For transverse module, B equal to R by psi y, so 8.54 divided by 3 equal to 2.85. Now MT equal to transverse module, MT equal to average module plus B by Z1 sin delta 1, so 0.464 plus 2.85 divided by 17 with the sin 18.43 equal to 0.517 centimeter. Next higher module from table number 1, it is 0.55 or 5.5 millimeter. Now we calculate the parameter bevel gear drive of the properties of the bevel gear drive. The equations are available in the table number 31, page number 8.38. Number of teeth on the gear, I into Z1, 3 into 1751. PCD of the pinion, D1 equal to MT into Z1, 0.55 into 17 equal to 9.35 centimeter. PCD of the gear, MT into Z2, 0.55 into 51, 28.05 centimeter. Tip diameter of the pinion, DA1 equal to MT into Z1 plus 2 into cos delta 1. it is 0.55 into 17 plus 2 into cos 18.43 equal to 10.4 centimeter, and tip circle, tip diameter of the gear DA2 equal to MT into Z2 plus 2 into cos delta 1 equal to 0.55 into 51 plus 2 into cos 18.43 equal to 29.1 centimeter. Then we calculate the cone distance R equal to 0.5 into transverse module MT into square root of Z1 square plus Z2 square, which is 0.5 into 0.55 into square root of 17 square plus 51 square equal to 14.78 centimeter. So the value is higher than the previous value. Earlier we calculated 8.54, now it is 14.78 centimeter. Then we calculate the face width. There are two equations for the face width, B equal to R by psi y, 14.78 divided by 3 equal to 4.93 centimeter, and B is also equal to 10 into MT, which is 10 into 0.55 equal to 5.5 centimeter. So we fix the smaller value, face width B equal to 4.93 centimeter. Then we average pitch diameter of the bevel pinion, D1 average equal to MT into Z1 into R minus 0.5B divided by R, calculating 0.55 into 17 into 14.78 minus 0.5 into 4.93 divided by 14.78 equal to 7.79 centimeter. And the B by D1 average equal to 4.93 divided by 7.79 equal to 0.63. Now the load consideration factor from table number 14, for harness value less than 350, BHL less than 350, and B by D1 average value 0.63, K value equal to 1.1. Then we calculate the pitch line velocity, V equal to pi D1 average N1 divided by 60. Pi into 0.0779 into 360 divided by 60 equal to 1.47 meters per second, and dynamic load factor equal to 1 from table number 15 for the velocity equal to 1.47 meters per second. Now we calculate the design torque for checking purpose, MT within bracket equal to MT into KKD. So 2535.6 into 1.1 into 1 equal to 2789.16 kilogram 4 centimeter. Then check for the surface stress. Equation is there in 8.13. Sigma C equal to 0.72 divided by R into 0.5B into square root of I square plus 1 to the power 1.5 divided by IB into E into MT, Young's modulus into MT. Substitute in numerical values, 0.72 divided by 14.78 minus 0.5 into 4.93. into square root of 3 square plus 1 to the power 1.5 divided by 3 into 4.93 into 1.7 into 10 power 6 into 2789.16, calculating sigma C equal to 5886.7, which is less than 14575 kilogram force per centimeter square. So the actual compressive stress is less than the design compressive stress, so the design is safe. Next, we have to check for the bending stress. We take alpha pressure angle equal to 20 degree, sigma B equal to R cone distance to the square root of I square plus 1 divided by R minus 0.5 B whole square into design torque divided by BM YV into cos alpha. So, substitute in numerical value, sigma B equal to 14.78 into square root of 3 square plus 1 divided by 14.78 minus 0.5 into 4.93 whole square into 2789.16 divided by 4.93 into 0.55 into 0.308 into cos 20, calculating sigma B equal to 1095.3. The value is less than 1321.6, the design bending stress. So the design is safe. The actual bending stress is less than the design bending stress, so the design is safe. We stop here. So this is the procedure to solve the bevel gear problem. You follow the procedure and solve the problem on your own, so that you will be familiar with the data, equations in the data book, and the use of the calculator also will be familiar when you solve the problem on your own. Listen to the procedure, take a problem and solve, so that you will get the confidence in solving problem in the university examination. So these are all the books I publish in the mechanical engineering subject, and I upload the video lectures of the subject in the YouTube channel. You subscribe to the channel. use the videos for your better learning. Thank you for watching. Please post your comments in the comments box. You can contact me to my mail ID or WhatsApp number for any clarification on the subject. We'll meet again in another video with the two more problems in the bevel grid design.